We are sitting here at Silvan's computer. He is taking the lead in the whole project. We have two screens. One is the on-shape screen, 3D modeling, and the other one is where we do the math, so the basics. There are a lot of Excel stuff going on because we need to make basic decisions in the beginning, lay out Newton meters, what kind of forces are coming in which places, what kind of escapement forces do we want to have. So this is the basics, it's more like a strategic decision. Out of that, then we calculate amount of teeth per wheel, what are the distances, what are the transmission ratios, what kind of module we are using. And from there, we are actually putting that into 3D construction. Everything you see here is very familiar to us. We looked in our K1 and K2 designs and said, okay, what do we have? What can we modify in the right way that we can predict the outcome? I'm explaining a little bit how that movement actually works for everybody. That's the winding stem, obviously. This is a hand setting mechanism, which we use from K1. It has three steps. We will reduce it to two because a hand round movement and there's no calendar, so we need to have only one step. You pull out that stem, then you engage actually with this set of gears. This set of gears engage with the hands setting, with the hands itself. They are held in place by the hands friction mechanism so that they don't flicker and you can set them correctly. So when you have pulled that, you can adjust actually the time. When you put it back in, then you engage through the ratchet wheel, which we see afterwards when turning around, with the main barrel. Change the shape and the amount of teeth on the barrel in order to increase the power reserve. And we can do that because our escapement, which here is at the end, has a very high efficiency and we don't need so much force coming in. On our original movement, which we were using, it was basically a 70-70-50, probably done 40 years ago, I don't know. We have the math and the capabilities to also simulate and calculate the gear efficiency. So we are applying different gears where we know that the outcome is better. When you are winding that, then obviously the energy will be released slowly through this gear train. That's a second wheel, it turns 60 times per minute, 60 steps, 1 second, one time around. That's a transfer wheel, and then you are actually engaging, that's not shown here, with the whole tourbillon cage, which we fundamentally change actually. So what is fundamentally different? You can see here the barrel from the back. There's also empty, that'd be a ratchet wheel to avoid the barrel unwinding in the wrong direction. So the energy needs to go that way, and then it will be step by step released by actually the ticking of the watch, which is the escapement. We actually put a ball bearing there instead of two stones because this is much more shock resistant and it allows us to better assemble the movement. That's a pretty tricky part, but we are confident that that's the right decision. When we design that cage, you also need to make sure that it's completely balanced so we can calculate through the cut tool that, because it's not a symmetric part in itself, so you need to make sure that the weight in itself is centered to the center point and that it's also easy to assemble and that the whole thing is round because you need to cut gears on that. That's the next step. You see here there are no gears cut yet. That's what you're doing right now. After you get the numbers from different tools, specifically some gear shape tools, then you draw them step by step. And that's how that whole movement is actually from the functional side. The plate is something which you do at the end. The movement doesn't work because of a plate. The plate is just holding the whole gear system in place and assures that all these different distances are correct. So this is how it looks without cutting out. And when all that is correctly done, then we go in and say, okay, we want to have it look exactly the same like it was before. It might be that we have to change one or two of these cutouts dependent on some relocation of some parts. But basically, this is the look which we will keep. But really differences in the detail, but big differences leading to a much better product. So, and we will keep you posted next time. We will talk much more about the tourbillon cage itself and the construction itself. So we let you really look into what we are doing here and you can become a watchmaking expert at the end of the day.